How big is traditional variety of rice? Origin and history. India is an important center of rice cultivation. The two major variety grown worldwide today are Oryza sativa indica and Oryza sativa japonica. History says that indica variety was first domesticated in the foothills of eastern Himalaya, Burma, Thailand, Vietnam and southern China. Japonica was domesticated in southern China. Today, the majority of rice produced are from China, India, Indonesia, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Vietnam, Thailand, Philippines, and Japan. Asian farmers account for about 92% of the total world rice production. We are going to enforce on the traditional variety of rice, Basmati, a long grain grown in India and Pakistan, which is most commonly grown in Punjab region, which is notable for its fragrance and delicate. It is available in white and brown variety. The flavor is caused by the aroma compound 2-acetyl-1-pyroline. The traditional types of basmati are Basmati 370 and Basmati 385. The hybrid types are Pusa Basmati 1. Ambe Mohor rice, a variety from western Maharashtra. It has a tendency for easy breaking and stick together. Popular for its strong fragrance of mango blossom when it is cooked. It is preferred for its softness and easy chewing. It is similar to Soot Kolam, a variety from Gujarat. Dubraj rice, an aromatic short to medium grain, commonly in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. It is found with an intermediate amylose and genitalization temperature. Joha rice, cultivated largely in Assam, which is notable for its aroma, delicate and excellent taste. Two traditional types of Joha rice are Tulsi Joha and Kala Joha. Kerala Matta rice, an indigenous variety grown in Palakkad, which is also known as Rose Matta or Kerala Red. It is basically different from other brown rices. Patna rice, a variety of a long grain cultivated in Indo-Gangetic plains. It is known for its elongated kernel. A grain length is about greater than 6 mm, that is robust, long, narrow and an opaque grain. Sona Masuri rice, a medium grain grown in Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tiruchi, also known as Samba Masuri BPT5204 HMT, well known for its light weight, containing less starch and easily digestible. The main drawback of Sona Masuri is susceptibility to blast disease and brown plant hopper due to heavy dose of nitrogenous fertilizer. Navara rice, origin in Kerala and are endemic, used in special treatments of neuromuscular disorders like backache, circulatory, respiratory, digestive and nervous system disorder. It is also used in religious significance such as in temples for ceremonies. Now we are going to focus on Tamil Nadu traditional rice varieties. Kadai Kaludan, 165 days crop, which is grown in clayey and sandy soil, which is well suited for good drainage facility. It is also known as Garudan Samba and it is suitable for South Indian meals, which is widely cultivated in July and January. Kattukuttalam rice, a 125 days crop, cultivated in sandy clay soil either by dry sowing or by transplantation. It is a red colored and a coarse rice, which is suitable for making idli and dosas. The grain of Kattukuthalam is quite heavy. Kalundai rice, a 110-day crop grown in sandy soil and cultivated in coastal areas between the months of October to March. It's a brown-colored and coarse rice, which is widely suitable for making breakfast dishes like idli and dosas. Chengalpattu Sirimani, a 165-day crop grown in Chengalpattu district of Tamil Nadu in waterlogged area. It is suitable in sandy clay and alluvial soil. Chengalpattu Sirimani is a white and a coarse rice of an high yielding variety. The average yield of Chengalpattu Sirimani is about 1500 kg per acre. It is used in making paniyarams. Thooya Malli means pure jasmine since it is white in color. At the flowering stage, the ear head looks like a flower. It is highly resistant to pest and disease and suitable for making South Indian meals like biryani. Siraga Samba rice. The rice resembles the shape of a spice siragam. Hence, it got the name Siraga Samba. It is extremely fine and an aromatic rice. Siraga Samba fetches the highest price among all the indigenous paddy variety. It is used in making biryani. Pisni rice. It has to be taken extra care while removing the grain since the ear head are found with on. They are extremely drought resistant and it is widely used in making dosa, porridge and aval. Kappa Samba. At flowering stage, they have a needle-like horn at the tip of the grain, but on maturity, it falls off. They are highly resistant to pest and disease. It is widely used in making idli, dosa and South Indian meals. Special and outstanding traditional rice variety of India. Dryland variety, Kela and Butmuri. Deep water variety, Jabra, Lakshmi Dighal and Patnara. Disease resistant variety, bacterial leaf blight, Asanlea, Ashpakal, Bankatar and Hiramoti. Bacterial leaf spot and leaf streak disease, Butamuri and Banskadir. Blast disease, Kola Nunia, Kashbinia and Tulsi Manjori. Tungro virus, Patar Bogi. Pest resistant variety, case worm resistant, Gangajal, Sharital and Balam. Brown plant hopper resistance, Daral Nugna. Stem borer resistance, Sindur Mukhi. Tall varieties, Agnisal, Ashu, Bahup Rupi, Bansmati, Gaurnita. Semi-draft varieties, Chakramala, Mala, Narayan Mani. Long straw yielding varieties, Bans Kadir, Darkasal, Kalam Kadir, Kalma, Lakshmi Chura and Padmasal. Fragrant rice variety, Bimsal, China Kamini, Choto Nunia, Danguri. Medicinal rice variety, Batmuri, cures anemia and enchants blood circulation in women after giving birth. Parmai Sal has special nutritional value for strength. High yielding variety, Punjab Sal, Bahupuri, Jugal, Kabiraj Sal and Darka Sal. Though there are many traditional varieties, there was a replacement with a modern rice variety. Due to initial high yield, cost of external input, subsequent loss of non-grain biomass, loss of desirable trait like tolerance to disease, pest, drought and floods.